رواه أبو جنة حفظكم الله وضعاكم. And I know Dr. Lawar when I was in Iraq, mashallah. And believe me, you are very lucky. You have like this alimun, wari'un, taqeen. Wahuwa, and he is famous professor in the Islamic University in Baghdad in A'damiyya. And everyone, when I spoke with my friends and in Iraq with the ulama, I told them I would go to Dr. Lawar, mashallah. And also they told me, you are lucky when you meet with Dr. Lawar. Believe me, brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a great barakah. Because I feel Dr. Lawar, when he was in Iraq, he has ikhlas, sincerity, subhanallah. I don't like to honor him direct, but believe me, wallahi, you are lucky. And if he accept, he come to Tucson, I will take him. Wallahi.
He's not coming.
Allah.
Inshallah, he stays here for us.
And inshallah, I want to start. Do you have time?
Alhamdulillah.
Until maybe we'll continue after Isha.
Yes,
yeah. Because you know, because this is a good opportunity to meet with you, inshallah ta'ala. Brother, can you sit here, please? I want to see everyone. No, sit there, no problem. I want to see all the faces, mashallah. This is Noor faces, mashallah. Barakallah. I want, in the beginning, before I start with my lecture. Yeah, jazakallah khair, mashallah, because I want your light come to me, you know? Because this is give me a way to fatah, you know, to open, inshallah ta'ala. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah ta'ala, was said, al-isnadu min ad-deen. The isnad mean when you get the ijazah, the certificate from your sheikh. Like I take my from my sheikh take from his sheikh take from his sheikh until Hadrat Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this thing, this isnad, especially for Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abdullah ibn Mubarak said, al-isnadu min ad-deen. And the first isnad, al-isnadu fil Qur'an al-Kareem. Al-isnad about al-Qur'an al-Kareem. Who start with this thing? That isnad started by Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, when he asked Sayyidina Zayd ibn Thabit to collect all the pages of the Quran and put it in one mushaf. This is dalil of isnad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidun. By the way of isnad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect his Quran and protect our deen. And start, look, Sayyidina Umar said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, how you do something Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do it? فقال له, he said to, إنه خير, This is khayr. This means Sayyidina Abu Bakr, the first one, make bid'ah. Because in the time of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Quran was not in the one cover, one book. Right? But من سن في الإسلام سنة حسنة, who give a good tradition in Islam, فله أجرها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him about this sunnah. This sunnah, a good sunnah. من سن في الإسلام سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. And the ajr, Allah will give the ajr to who follow this in new sunnah. And that sunnah from where? From, not from their mind. That sunnah from Quran, and they have the leel from the Quran and sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ سَنَّ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ سُنَّةً سَيِّئًا. If anyone give new bid'ah, new things, this will bad bid'ah. Because Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, he divided the word of bid'ah with the five of aqsam al-hukm al-takleefi. Like, sometimes, The new bid'ah, because what does mean bid'ah in linguistic? كُلُّ أَمْرٍ مُسْتَحْدَثٍ, something new. But if that new thing follow the Qur'an and Sunnah, مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدُّ. If Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because some people they don't understand about وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٌ ضَلَالَ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٌ فِي النَّارِ. They don't understand what does mean. Oh, this is everything, this bid'ah is ضَلَالَة. This is not correct. Because if that new thing وَافَقَ, agree with the Qur'an and Sunnah, this is mean a good bid'ah. Like جمع القرآن is a new bid'ah, right? But this new bid'ah agree with Al-Quran and Sunnah. Another thing, Salat al-Tarawih, example. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pray three or four times. This is in the authentic hadith. And he left Salat al-Tarawih. He left Salat al-Tarawih because he said, I fear maybe this come to you, obligatory upon you, and you can't do it that. This continue, no one from Sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed Salat al-Tarawih in the time of Khilafat Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And the middle of Khilafat Sayyidina Umar. Until one day, one night, Sayyidina Umar entered the masjid and saw the Sahaba came in the night of Ramadan and prayed with a lot of Sahaba in the masjid of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And when he entered the masjid, and so the Sahaba prays Salat al-Tarawih, what he said, Sayyidina Umar? Anyone tell me? He said, Ni'matul bid'ah. Salat al-Tarawih, Ni'matul bid'ah. Yani, a good bid'ah. Again, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, put the word of Lamdul bid'ah in the أقسام الحكم التكليفي, ربما تكون واجبة أو تكون سنة أو تكون مكروهة أو تكون محرمة. فما كان خارج نطاق الكتاب والسنة ولم يفعلها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يفعلها الصحابة وكانت زيادة في الدين هذه البدعة المقصودة وكل بدعة ضلالة أي وكل بدعة سيئة ضلالة ما ليس عليه أمرنا في الحديث إن ذا الحديث ما ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد يعني مردود على صاحبها وتعتبر بدعة مضلة. Do you understand, brothers? And we have a lot of things after that. Many. But all of these come with hadith من سن في الإسلام سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة ومن سن في الإسلام سنة سيئة فعليه وزرها ووزر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. The new things الإسناد. And I told you الإسناد عبد الله بن مبارك رحمه الله تعالى said الإسناد من الدين. The إسناد the سلسلة من الدين from the religion. ولولا الإسناد if the إسناد did not come that time لقال من شاء ما شاء. If without إسناد anyone he can say anything he want. Okay? لقال من شاء ما شاء. What he like, what he want. For this, أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم is أمة الإسناد. For this, when we see Imam al-Bukhari, he put a lot of conditions from who will take his hadith before him, from Tabi'een and from Tabi'een and Tabi'een and الصحابة رضوان الله تعالى عليه وسلم from حضرة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Same thing Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, same thing with Imam al-Bukhari and other scholars. For this knowledge اختص به علماء الحديث رحمهم الله تعالى for شو نقول توثيق documentation of correct and authentic hadith because the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said من كذب علي متعمدا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. If anyone say incorrect on me should prepare his seat in the fire. عادنا الله وإياكم من النار. الإمام أبو علي الجياني رحمه الله تعالى he was died in the 427 هجري. He was big imam of hadith and Arabic language and poetry. في الشعر كان أستاذا في الحديث واللغة العربية والشعر. Said خص الله تعالى هذه الأمة بثلاثة خصال بثلاثة أشياء. الله سبحانه وتعالى make this أمة أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم with special three things. He did not give these three things to another أمة. The first one الإسناد. الإسناد. The second thing الأنساب. أنساب العرب. Like يسمون القبائل. The tribes of the tribes of community. And الإعراب. Also الإعراب means the grammar of Arabic language. For this one we want understand the Quran should know about what does mean that in the grammar in Arabic language. This is the introduction of what I want to do today. Inshallah, I will give إجازة في العلوم النقلية والعقلية about إسناد to الشيخ الدكتور رواه إن شاء الله. And when I recite the سند, you will see all the إسناد until حضرة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم to سيد جبريل to, because when we remember those names of إسناد, the ملائكه will cover us and the رحمه will come down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. عند ذكر الصالحين تتنزل الرحمه. When we mention the names of righteousness, Allah revealed to us mercy. Can you give me the ijazah, Shaykh? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Be patient because this is in Arabic language. الحمد لله الذي جعل العلماء ورثة الأنبياء والمرسلين ونور قلوبهم بأشعة أسرار اليقين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد مدينة علوم الأولين والآخرين وعلى آله بروج فلك الهداية وأساس أصول الدين وأصحابه الناطقين ببيان معاني الأحاديث البديعة مع أنحاء البراهين. وبعد، فقد استجازني أخي في الدين الدكتور رواه محمود حسين محبة له بارتباطه بسلسلة إجازتنا الشريفة، فأجزته بتعليم ما وفقه الله تعالى على تعليمه من العلوم الدينية والفقهية، كما أجازني شيخي وأستاذي خادم العلم والدين الملقب بالشافعي الصغير مفتي الديار العراقية الشيخ العلامة عبد الكريم المدرس في الحضرة القادرية المباركة رحمه الله تعالى، كما أجازه الشيخ عمر القرداني عن الشيخ العلامة المحقق الفهام الشيخ محمد نجيب القرداني، وهو أخذ الإجازة عن عمه سيد المحققين وسند المدققين الشيخ حسن عن العلامة المشتهر في الآفاق مفتي العراق مولانا محمد الزهاوي، وهو أخذ الإجازة عن العلامة الجامع بين المعقول والمنقول المتحلي بفنون الفروع والأصول مولانا محمد بن رسول الساوجبلاغي، عن العلامة السائل علمي كالنهر الجاري مولانا صالح التلمباري عليه رحمة الملك الباري، عن العلامة النحرير العبقري مولانا صالح أفندي الحيدري عليه رحمة الملك الأكبر، عن العلامة النحرير العبقري مولانا صالح أفندي الحيدري عليه رحمة الملك الأكبر، عن العالم الجليل والفاضل النبيل مولانا إسماعيل عليه رحمة الملك الجليل، عن أستاذه الذي يسيل علمه كسيل الوادي على أهل البلاد والبوادي صبغة الله أفندي الحيدري الحسين آبادي عليه رحمة الملك الهادي، عن والده الأعلم الأفخر مولانا إبراهيم بن حيدر نور الله مقامه عن والده الأكرم الأنجد حيدر بن أحمد رحمة الملك الصمد عن والده الأعظم الأنور أحمد بن حيدر عليه رحمة الملك الأكبر عن والده الأفخم الأكمل حيدر الأول عليه رحمة الملك الأجل عن صدر المحققين غواص بحار المعاني مولانا زين الدين الكردي البلاتي عن أستاذه صاحب المعالي مولانا نصر الدين خلخالي عليه رحمة الملك الوالي عن الصياد في بحر مغاني المعاني مولانا جمال الدين ميرزا جان الشيرازي عن المولى جمال الدين محمود الكشكناري عن المولى جلال الدين الدواني عن والده سعد الملة والدين محمد الصديق الدواني عن أستاذ البشر العقل الحادي عشر السيد شريف الجرجاني عن مولانا مبارك شاه البخاري عن مولانا قطب الدين الرازي عن المولى العلامة الشيرازي عن المولى عمر الكاتب القزويني عن الإمام فخر الدين الرازي صاحب التفسير الكبير عن والده عمر الرازي عن حجة الإسلام الإمام محمد الغزالي عن إمام الحرمين عبد الملك الجويني عن الشيخ أبي طالب المكي عن الشيخ أبي عثمان المغربي عن الشيخ أبي عمرو الزجاجي عن سيد الطائفة الشيخ جنيد البغدادي عن الشيخ أبي الحسن السري السقطي عن الشيخ معروف الكرخي عن الشيخ أبي سليم داود الطائي عن الشيخ حبيب العجمي عن الشيخ التابعي الكبير الحسن البصري قدس الله أسرارهم ونفعنا ببركاتهم عن حضرة الإمام والخليفة الهمام باب مدينة علم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد الزهراء البتول أسد الله الغالب علي بن أبي طالب كرم الله وجهه عن حضرة منبع الشريعة الغراء وخاتم الرسل والأنبياء سيدنا محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الناموس الأكبر جبرائيل عليه السلام عن الله تعالى رب العالمين عز وجل وأنا الفقير الخادم للعلم والدين واثق بن فؤاد بن محمد أمين العبيدي الحنفي إمام وخطيب جامع الإمام الأعظم ومدير مدرسة سيدنا الشيخ عبد القادر الجيلاني نور الله ضريحه وأفادنا ببركاته سابقا ورئيس ومفتي مركز الإمام أبي حنيفة الإسلامي مدينة توسان ولاية أريزونا في الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية قد أجزت أخي في الله الدكتور رواء هذه الإجازة المباركة وهو وله الحق في إجازة من يراه كفءاً للإجازة وحمل الأمانة فأوصيك يا فضيلة الشيخ بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته وأن تعمل بعلمك وأن يفتح الله عليك فتوح العارفين إنه على ما يشاء قدير وبالإجابة جدير
تكبير
تكبير الله أكبر
Takbir!
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
Mubarak, inshaAllah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Jazakum Allah khair. I would like to thank my Shaykh, Dr. Wathiq Alobaidi, for giving me this ijazah. I would like to let you know, dear brothers, that I'm waiting for this ijazah more than 25 years right now. More than 25 years, I'm waiting for this ijazah. Shaykh Wathiq told me, we were talking before 2 days, he said, I'm going to give it to you right away. He said, I studied with my Sheikh, the Mufti of Iraq, Imam Sheikh Abdul Karim Biyara, Al-Mudarris bin Habrat Al-Qadiriyya, for more than 12 years to give me this ijazah. And Sheikh Dr. Wathiq has a student, he studied with him for more than 7 years to get this ijazah. This ijazah is very dear brothers, very, very important. Without it, you will not be qualified to teach the Islamic studies, especially, dear brothers. This ijazah comes from Sheikh Abdul Karim al-Mudarris Biyara. Sheikh Biyara was the Mufti of Iraq. And Jazakumullah khair. وأنت تستحق هذا الشيء. Let us speak to our brother, our beloved brother Muhammad Al-Azawi, asked me to speak something about Sayyidina Imam Abu Hanifa Alnuman, rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala was born in Kufa. 80-year Hijri. And he grew up, rahimahullah ta'ala, in Kufa. And he was very close from many of Sahabat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that time. He said, I went to Basra and I met Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu when he was in Basra in that time. And the scholars said, Abu Hanifa met with some, they said, 7 Sahabi, and other they said 6, other they said 36 Sahabi. And when he went to Basra and sit with Anas, he take the hadith from Anas. You know, Sayyidina Anas was the servant of our Hawlat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His mother brought him to Hawlat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, O Messenger of Allah, this is my son, Anas. Make him your servant. Sayyidina Anas said, يقول خدمت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 سنين. I served Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 years. He didn't tell me what do that or why did that thing. Because he is صلى الله عليه وسلم الرحمة الإلهية. Sayyidina Abu Hanifa take hadith from Anas with the Isnad. When we speak about Islam, he said,
when he met with him and he gave him that hadith. When an Anas ibn Malik, an Abi Hanifa Alnuman, an Anas ibn Malik, أنه قال قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. طلب العلم and learn of علم of knowledge of Islam is فريضة is obligatory. فريضة upon every Muslim and Muslim. Imam Abu Hanifa, he was a big scholar and he started, he memorized the Quran when he was very young, radiallahu anhu. But he was very busy because his dad was a tajir, trade, a businessman. And he was staying with his dad. Until he come 40 years old and start to go to the Hilq al-Ilm. And he got, he met with more than 4,000 sheikh. Imam Abu Hanifa sit with 4,000 sheikh. He sit with Ahlul Kalam, you know? You know Ahlul Kalam mean Ahlul Aqidah, who speak like Al-Mu'tazila, like Al-Murji'a, like Al-Khawarij, and he sat with Al-Dahriyin, he sat with all of them. And he said, I don't take benefit, you know. And he went, but he get a lot of knowledge about Aqidah. And also, he has a great book, that book, Al-Fiqh Al-Akbar. Al-Fiqh Al-Akbar, Lil-Imami Abi Hanifa رحمه الله تعالى. And he went to محدثين and also said and learned a lot of and memorized a lot of hadith. And he said, okay, if I take and maybe someday accept the hadith and another one did not accept the hadith. He said, also I have something about knowledge of hadith because also he is محدث. And Al-A'zami, he written the book of Musnad al-Imam Abi Hanifa al-Nu'man with 10,000 hadith come, he istakhraj derived his hadith from his fiqh. When the أحكام الفقه للإمام أبي حنيفة رحمه الله تعالى. And he lived there until he found his sheikh حماد بن سليمان رحمه الله تعالى. He sat with his sheikh. حماد was القاضي in that time. Imam Abu Hanifa, after something, a few years, he want move with different halaqa. And his sheikh sent some people to ask him a question. He don't have any answer about this question. And he said, okay, I will return back to my sheikh. Okay? In that time, stay with Imam, with his sheikh, Al-Imam Hamad, rahimahullah ta'ala, 18 years. Until he come the best student with his sheikh. When his sheikh got some trouble, Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah ta'ala, lead that halaqa of fiqh. He found himself with al-fiqh. For this, they said al-faqih al-aqdam. He is the old faqih. He is the first one start with fiqh, with the fiqh. And A lot of scholars, they honor Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, "An-nasu ayalun bil-fiqhi ala Abi Hanifa." Everyone, all the scholars, they need the fiqh of Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam, and also a person asked Imam Malik in the Medina, "Oh Imam, did you meet with Abu Hanifa?" He said, "Yes." "How you saw him?" He said, Imam Malik, "رأيت رجلا," I saw a man, "لو كلمك في هذه السارية," if he won't speak about this pillar in the masjid from rocks, if he won't make that pillar come from gold, will do it with his dalil, with his hujjah, with his evidence, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahullahu ta'ala, anyone come to him, ask him some question. The first thing, ask what Imam, and look at what Imam Abu Hanifa said about that mas'ala and that hukum. Imam Abu Hanifa was famous Imam, and he had he get two calamities in his time, in his life. The first time with the al-Dawla al-Umawiyya, with the Umayyad time, because he was supported the Thawrat al-Bayt, Thawrat Zayd ibn Ali ibn Hussein ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And Imam Abu Hanifa opened his account for Imam Zayd rahimahullahu ta'ala wa radiyallahu anhu ajma'in. And another musibah, another calamity with Imam Abu Hanifa came in the time of Ad-Dawla al-Abbasiyya with Ibn Hubayra. Ibn Hubayra was a wali of Madinatul Kufa, and they jealous, يعني عندهم يغارون منهم, jealous, correct? كانوا يغارون منه, they are jealous for him because he was big عالم and big knowledge, and he has big part when Abu Ja'far al-Mansur رحمه الله تعالى built مدينة بغداد. Abu Hanifa also was alim, he has some knowledge with the riyadiyat, with mathematics, رحمه الله تعالى. And he, كيف نقول, he accounted how many rags, how many stone need for build the fence of Baghdad in the time of Abu Ja'far al-Mansur rahimahullah ta'ala. And they asked him for be a qadi al-qudat in Baghdad, but he did فالإمام أبو حنيفة رحمه الله تعالى كان علمه يعني أكثر المسائل في المسائل الافتراضية. What does mean افتراضية? He has more than 40,000 مسألة في العلم الافتراضي. You know, 4,000 without heaven that time. And some scholar asked him, Abu Hanifa, or when he was asked Shaykh, Abu Hanifa, if that, يعني هل هذا الشيء هذه المسألة حصلت? This thing happened? He said no. But we are as a scholar, we are as ulama, find answer to our community when they will ask. Imam Abu Hanifa, he was follow Al-Quran, the first thing. And if he, like Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal, رضي الله تعالى عنه وارضاه رسول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم sent him to Yemen and he said, oh Mu'adh, if any question come to you, how can you answer that hukum? He said, I will look to Quran. Okay, if you do not find in the Quran, he said, I will look into Sunnah al-Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you don't find, oh Mu'adh, he said, أجتهد رأيي إلى آله يا رسول الله. I will make اجتهاد in my رأي, okay, from my mind, okay. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم put his hand on his chest. فقال الحمد لله الذي وفق رسول الله لما يرضي الله ورسوله. سبحان الله. سيدنا أبو حنيفة like this way. If anyone asks him, he look into Quran. And if he do not find in the Quran, he will go to Sunnah al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he, if don't find in the Quran and Sunnah, he is looking towards the Sahaba said about this mas'ala, this question. And sometimes they come different between the Sahaba, because the Sahaba, someone, when the Islam separated to everywhere in the earth, okay? Some Sahaba they heard from Prophet ﷺ something, and those Sahaba they didn't hear that hadith from Hadith Rasul ﷺ. For this, come the ta'arub al-ahadith. What mean ta'arub?
Conflict of hadith.
For this, Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala, he's the first one who written book Al-Muwatta before Imam Al-Bukhari. You know, before Imam Al-Bukhari, Imam Malik, he has a great book of hadith, Kitab Al-Muwatta, Imam Malik, rahimahullah ta'ala. When Abu Ja'far al-Mansur visit Imam Malik, and Imam Malik give him a gift copy of that book. And he said, okay, this is a beautiful book and very good book, you know. I want make a lot of copies and send it to Al-Afaq, to our Ummah everywhere in the land at that time. He said, no Imam, don't do it. Oh Khalifa, don't do that. He said, why? Because this book are written from the generation of At-Tabi'in, and At-Tabi'in take it from the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ, from Hadith, who stayed and didn't leave Al-Madinah. And a lot of Sahaba, they went everywhere. For this is big reason about Asbab Ikhtilaf Al-Fuqaha. And وَكُلُّهُمْ مُنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ مُلْتَمِسٌ. All of them, they are right. Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. All of them, they are correct. And all of them, they are right. Okay? Will not say, oh Abu Hanifa, you don't understand. Or Imam Malik. No, don't say that. Respect. Respect all of
all of them. And after that, Imam Abu Hanifa, when he looked into mas'ala about what the Sahaba said about this mas'ala, and come some difference between or among the Sahaba, he choose the with his conditions from the Sahaba. What does mean that? If the hadith is in the في أسباب اختلاف الفقهاء and مناهج منهاج الفقهاء يعني how they take when they take from Quran and Sunnah and also from the Sahaba. If the two hadith come from the Sahaba, one hadith like narrated by Salim مولى ابن عمر بن الخطاب سالم مولى عبد الله بن عمر بن الخطاب and another hadith come something different and that hadith come narrated by عبد الله بن مسعود or علي بن أبي طالب is both hadith is authentic. That hadith came from سالم مولى ابن عمر is سالم صحابي is big صحابي سالم مولى ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى and بمحدد رضي الله تعالى but he was young man when he entered Islam when the hadith same thing but different when the hadith come from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud Imam Abu Hanifa he will leave if he can make يجمع بينهما كبر حسن those two hadith He did. But if he can do it that, he will leave the hadith of Salim Mawla ibn Umar and take hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud or Ali ibn Abi Talib or Umar ibn Khattab. Okay? This why the ulama come different, but we should follow those ulama, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, because those they were in the best centuries. خير قرون قرني الذي أنا فيهم ثم الذين يلونهما or in another way ثم الذي يلي ثم الذي يلي. Three centuries after the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the best century. Inshallah, I will not go far because I know the time, but one day look to fiqh Imam Abu Hanifa. A lady came to him when he was around his student, and this woman bring apple. That apple red and yellow, red and different color, and she put it that apple on the hand of Imam Abu Hanifa. And Imam Abu Hanifa, what he did, he cut that apple and he gave her like that and showed her inside of the apple, and she left. Thank you, Jazakallah khair, and she left. And his student told him, oh Imam, what happened? This woman is crazy or what? He said, no, this woman, she had a knowledge of Sharia. And she saw her blood, sometimes yellow and red. When women come pure, and I show her when I cut that apple, I show her when she will see the white color. The white color. This is ilm Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala. He was very smart man. One day he was with his student, give his lesson, and a snake come direct to his lap, and he didn't do it anything, just Bismillah, and that snake without scared. Subhanallah, this is karama for Sayyidina al-Imam Abu Hanifa. Another person came to, oh Imam, Biwar or Biwawain. Okay, what the word? And he left. He said, what happened with this man? He said, he asked me about At-Tahiyyatu Lillahi, Was-Salawatu Wa-Tayyibat. Was-Salawat, this is the first two, Wa-Tayyibat. As-Salamu Alayka, Ayyuha Nabi. In the madhhab al-Imam Abi Hanifa, At-Tahiyyatu Lillahi, Was-Salawatu Wa-Tayyibat, As-Salamu Alayka, Ayyuha Nabi, Wa Rahmatullahi Wa Barakatuh. He asked about the Dawawain or At-Tahiyyatu Lillahi, At-Tayyibat al-Mubarakat. Like the way of Jumhur and Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala. When we speak about Sayyidina Imam Abu Hanifa, we have long time, because he is the Imamul Millah. Imamul Millati wa-Din. Imamul Millati wa-Din. The famous student, Imam Abu Yusuf in al-Ansari, he was Qadi al-Qubat in the time of Harun al-Rashid. From his karama of Imam Abu Hanifa, when Al-Qadi Abu Yusuf was with the Harun al-Rashid, he ate with the same plate with Khalifa al-Mu'mineen in the same plate. He said, okay, and Imam Abu Yusuf, he was crying. He said, what happened? He was poor people, but he was big alim, you know? He said, Harun Rashid told him, why you are crying, Qadi Abu Yusuf? He said, Subhanallah, may Allah have mercy on my teacher, Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man, rahimahullah. He said, why you mention his name in this time? He said, because he told me when I was, came to his halaqa, I was poor people, and my mother, she did not accept because she wanted me go to work and to job and find some money for help my family. And Imam Abu Hanifa, in that time, he put some money under my under my rug, okay? My rank. When I will finish, I will take that money and leave. And in that time, Abu Hanifa, when my mother came and told her, leave Abu Yusuf, because he will be eat with the same plate with a Khalifa. In that time, he said, I was love, how can I eat with some place, with Khalifa al-Muslimin in that time. You know, I know the time is for prayer. Asha, I'm so sorry.
We just want to call Azan and continue. We have time. We call Azan and we have more time.
Okay.
Sure.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة هيا على الصلاة هيا على الصلاة هيا على الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وسيلة الفضيلة وبعث اللهم مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته
Inshallah, we have the time. Just in case some people have some questions to share, we will have about 20 minutes.
Brothers, if you have any questions for the Sheikh, inshallah, the Sheikh is ready to answer all of your questions.
Some questions came up to the media, inshallah, it's about 3 to 4 questions. Based on when we started, you talk about a bid'ah. So someone asked, when we say bid'ah, what is the meaning of bid'ah? And what are the examples of bid'ah? So these are two before I go to the rest, inshallah.
Okay.
When I will start about the explain what does mean the bid'ah. البدعه هو كل امر مستحدث كل امر مستحدث everything coming new okay and I explained that and I gave you example about جمع القران when they make the قران this is if we want take لفظ البدعه in Arabic language okay and I told you what Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala and other scholars they put that word under أقسام الحكم التكليف okay okay heresy okay heresy sometimes that bid'ah come good sometimes that bid'ah is bad and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said وكل بدعة ضلالة he spoke about the bad bid'ah that bid'ah don't have أصل any proof any دليل in the Quran and Sunnah and صحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم
and question number two
the mic is not
And the question number two is so what who are the Al-Sunnah?
Al-Sunnati wal Jama'a. Haqiqatan, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul alaykum bi sunnati. عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي عضوا عليها بالنواجذ Follow my sunnah. What does mean sunnah? This is what does mean sunnah. A sunnah, the ulama explain and give us The definition of sunnah. As-sunnah هي أقوال. أقوال. وأفعال. And what he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم. What he did. And what he accepted. أفعال وأقرار. أفعال وأقوال. وتقريرات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. About the تقريرات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, this means he accepted some From Sahaba did that. When the Sayyidina Ammar ibn Nasir went somewhere in trouble with his friends and he was junub, you know? And that time was very cold. The Sahaba make wudu and Sayyidina Ammar put some dirty on his body. And the Sahaba ankaru alayhi. And they came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted what Sayyidina Ammar ibn Yasir did. This is the taqrirat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa hiya from sunnah. This is in the, yeah, this word, ma ma'na ahlu sunnah, هم المتبعون لحضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما قاله وما فعله وما أقره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهذا كله متعلق بعلم الإسلام أنا قلت لكم في هذا الموضوع في البداية هذا العلم كله والإسناد هو من البدع المبتدعة لكن لحفظ الدين بعد في زمن التابعين وظهر الكذب بدأ من العلماء من يدون حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم because some ulama they said that تدوين الحديث is بدعة because this Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did not accept anyone write what he said except القرآن من كتب عني شيئا فليمحو إلا القرآن except the Quran but in the another time he says some Sahaba write what said صلى الله عليه وسلم and he accepted صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم فأهل السنة هم المتبعون لحضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم actually you'll surprise about what I will say I don't like about أهل السنة and الشيعة because أهل السنة أهل السنة
yes.
أهل السنة the Shia when that come different we don't have another way in our deen this is come by politics Wallahu a'lam
now two more questions one more question but this one came so
this one is what is your take on the issue of Mawlid as a bid'ah or not
this is very good question when I will answer this question because some scholars they said this is bid'ah and this is what I was when I started bid'ah hasana and bid'ah sayyi'a okay and we have a lot of dalil from Quran and Sunnah okay actually we have big dalil but some they don't accept that dalil about bid'at al-mawlid bid'at al-hasana how Imam al-Suyuti rahimahullah ta'ala he has a great book you know Imam al-Suyuti he's a big muhaddith right he's from al-qarn al-ashir al-hijri tamam sheikh idha mathmun al-dhakir yani عنده كتاب he has a great book حسن المقصد ممرز اسمه حسن المقصد في عمل المولد you'll see the clear حكم not from me from this big عالم إمام السيوطي رحمه الله تعالى And if you read that book, I encourage everyone recite. You can go to Google and download this book, the Imam Suyuti, عمل حسن المقصد في عمل المولد. حسن المقصد في عمل المولد للإمام السيوطي رحمه الله تعالى. My opinion, follow the Mawlid is bid'atun hasan with condition that do not come women and men and make rappers and like dancer and do something this is we don't have dalil about that
no.
you know but about Mawlid Rasul Sallam in the Sahih Muslim سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن صيام يوم الاثنين Why you do fasting in the morning? He said ذلك يوم ولدت فيه That day, Monday, I was born And some, okay, how can do without no specific day when he was born? No, we know when he was born, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the prophets, and messengers, we don't know when they were born. But our glorious Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was born in Al-Fil, in the elephant year. This is the first time. Okay? And in the Rabi'ul Awwal, right? In the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. And the third thing, في يوم الاثنين. Year, elephant year, شهر ربيع الأول في يوم الاثنين. And some, okay, why do something Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't do it that? I told you. We follow the Quran and Sunnah. And Imam Muslim narrated about this hadith. سُئِلَ عَنْ صِيَامِ يَوْمِ الْإِثْنَيْنِ. If we do not get any benefit from Amal al-Mawlid except to recite the Sirat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and know about his Sirat, this is a great benefit. Because everyone will say, صَلُّ عَلَى النَّبِي اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد وسلم من صلى علي واحدة. Now you get, now you get 10 rewards.
الله أكبر.
With one prayer. Imam Muslim said, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة. صلى mean 10 times multiplier. Allah سبحانه وتعالى rewarded us. And also, you know, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he accepted without any innovation with fitna or new bid'ah, okay? Especially who live around the mushrikeen and kuffar, okay? Because now our children, they saw how the Christian make celebration about Christmas, right? And they came to us, why you don't make Mawlid Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? This question comes in the time of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, who speak about bid'ah, and he did not, sometimes he did not accept the Mawlid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But also he said, is no problem if will not come together with men and women and make rubbers, and if they come and make some food and some sweet and give some gift to other people and pray upon Prophet Muhammad and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together and make istighfar, this ma alayhi amru al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I told you, wa kullu bid'atin dalala. This means ما ليس عليها أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Is it clear?
No.
إن شاء الله تعالى. And the Quran told us about Ibn Abbas.
Last question.
But go to book of عمل المولد. حسن المقصد في عمل المولد للإمام السيوطي. We'll see all these details.
So last question also is, it says, can you list of matters where the four mazhab differ?
I answered this question in my lecture, right? During the lecture, you know? I told you about the...
Yeah, that was fine. The person who hears it, no problem.
Jazakallah khair. But yeah, thank you about this question, you know? Because khair, the hadith of Hadrat Rasul, خير القرون قرني الذي أنا فيه. The best century when I was living, and after that two centuries. And all these أربعة, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi, Imam Malik. I told you Imam Abu Hanifa was born in 80 Hijri. Imam Malik was born in 93 Hijri. Imam Shafi was born 150 Hijri, and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal was born, I think, 164, like this. And all of them, and also Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, all of them in the same three century, the best century, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about them.
Question?
Yes.
Apart from him, do you also, is anybody here have a question? Because we want to know how many people have a question so we can carry off. That's him. Two people. So after these two people, then we pray inshallah.
Inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum,
Shaykh.
My question is going to be in Arabic. It's very simple.
This is better for me.
سؤالي جمع القرآن إذا اعتبرت هي بدعة حسنة.
نعم.
هل يمكن اعتبارها يعني سنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعد القصر؟
نعم.
أيهما تصبر؟
Yes.
بدعة أما هي سنة في هذه الحالة؟
هي
أنا قلت لك ما معنى البدعة؟ البدعة هي كل أمر مستحدث، فلربما فيها دليل أو لم يوجد فيها دليل. وفعل الصحابة دليل، فعل الصحابة دليل، واضح؟ تأكيد اعتبرت سنة، واضح؟ والحديث واضح، من سن في الإسلام، أن من أوجد شيئا في الإسلام هذا الشيء حسن فإنه سنة حسنة وله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة والعكس كذلك.
Can you explain in English so those who are not in Arabic can benefit?
Now, do you have a question?
No, the
question
for
Sahara. Sahara.
That is why he's going to explain.
The Sheikh is saying that the Quran at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't combined in one book, because the Quran was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 23 years, according to many causes that happened, that faces the Muslims' society. So we know that there was a Quran revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Mecca and then in Al-Madinah. In the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, there was a battle called the Battle of Yamama. Many Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, many companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were killed in that battle. One of them came to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. He said, "Oh Abu Bakr, we are afraid that we will lose the Quran, because many of the Sahaba that they know the Quran, they memorize the Quran in their hearts, were killed in the Battle of Yamama. So please try to collect the Quran." The Quran was written on the papers, in the papers, on the walls, on the shoulders of the camels, and it was also memorized in the hearts of the Sahaba. So that Sahaba came to the Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave the order to start to collect the Quran.
To Zayd ibn Thabit.
To Zayd ibn Thabit, he hired a committee of four Sahaba. One of them was Zayd ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and then they started just to collect the Quran from the walls, from the papers, from the shoulders of the camels. They collected. This is called the first combination or completion of the Quran. This is the first one. At the time of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Uthman ibn Affan, who was the third Khalifa of Muslimin, he decided to write the Quran in the books. So the Quran was written in six copies, and Uthman ibn Affan ordered the Sahaba to distribute these six copies to the major cities in Islamic world, and he kept one of them in his house. He was reciting in the Quran. So the Sheikh is saying that if it was bid'ah, combination of the Quran, if it is bid'ah, then the Sahaba would not do it, right? And it was not done at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
And same thing with Taraweeh.
Adnan, yes. One question.
Yeah, it's the same question somebody asked about Ahmadi. And some people also call themselves like they are Wahhabi. So
we,
I don't brother, know, I don't like, what is the meaning of the Wahhabi?
His question, sir. Yes,
this is politics.
Specify
this is politics question. This is politics equation.
Well, this is, inshallah, you know, your question should be after Salat, meet Sheikh 101.
Yes.
This is the best, this is the best one. This type of question, meet the Imams 101, they will answer you. We are live on Facebook and everybody.
And anyone he can, anyone he has any question, you can send to my phone or to my to our website or to our to my Gmail.
Yeah, no, someone went to ask a question. We wanted to be done. Okay, then you are the last person after that. So I'm gonna make you go out. We done.
You told me only two questions.
He just came.
I am musafir. I can stay to morning, don't you?
Question regarding Zakat. A lot of people here, they trade. بيتجوا في السيارات, بيتجوا في البيوت أو أي شيء. هل في زكاة على المخزون السيارات المعدل البيع؟ وسهلا ما بتجرش في السيارات ولكن انا موضوع ما كنتش اعرف موضوع ان الانسان يخرج زكاه على الانفنتور.
نعم.
كان فما في
ما شاء الله. This is very very good question. ما شاء الله.
He asked our brother Jazam Akhir, this is very good question, an important question about zakat al man. About some, they are working with the dealer, right? And you know, we have with business work, okay, like dealer or like some they work with the buy and sell houses. This is with everything come in your account. In your account 1 year, وَحَالَ عَلَيْهِ الْحَوْلُ وَبَلَغَتِ النِّصَابِ. Okay? حَالَ staying in your account 1 year and بَلَغَتِ النِّصَابِ. النِّصَابِ مَا قِيمَتُهُ عشرون مِثْقَالًا. فَبِهَا نُصْفُ الْمِثْقَالِ. يعني هنا تقدر ب86 or 86 or 87 gram from gold, and you check that قيمته, how much in dollar, like 86 or 87 gram of gold, and give that 2.5. Okay, to al-asnaf, to eight sections or eight kinds of Psalms, zakat in ayah, in the ayah number 60 from Surah At-Tawbah, inshallah.
So,
but
it's here,
brother.
So, okay, so if I'm a car dealer and I have like 10 cars and this is for sale, okay, like next year, like the value of these cars are like, for example, $1,000, and this is balagh al-nisab. Next year I have like 15 cars. Do I have to pay zakat on that inventory that's in the parking lot?
You know, brother, very important, register everything.
Okay.
This...
مش على المال السائل, أنا أسف.
نعم.
مش على المال السائل.
نعم.
ليس على المال السائل, ولكن لو عندي سيارة معدة للبيع.
هي معدة للبيع. فهذه معدة للبيع. إذا بلغت النصاب وجب فيها الزكاة. نعم. 2.5. It's not a very big number, you know. It's very easy, you know. Like, if anyone he has like $100,000 every year, give the who needed that, like just 2,500.
Exactly.
That's it. It's very, very small number, inshallah. And also, the Hanafi Madhhab, for build the masajid will not accept zakah. But other scholars in the Hanafi, they accept with and agree with the Jumhur because they put it that fi sabilillah.
Okay?
Fi sabilillah. And if anyone he has zakah, for build our masjid, jazakumullah khair.
One second, Sheikh, we wanted you to pray. There's somebody just came in too. Just very quick, you are the last person. Bismillah. Bismillah, go ahead.
My question about bid'ah.
Can you check. This is just the same question, but it's asking about the hadith that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says before the end of the age, it's going to be 73 people. Only one who will be saved. Who are those people?
ما عليه أنا وأصحابي.
Okay, thank you. Very simple question. Check river.
Inshallah.
And I don't know what my sisters, if you have any question, we are middle ummah. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونُ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولوالدي ولسائر المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا معنا شقيا او محروما. اللهم بارك لاهل هذا المسجد, بارك لهم في اعمارهم وفي اولادهم وفي ازواجهم وفي ذرياتهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم وارزقنا واياهم رزقا طيبا حلالا كثيرا مباركا برحمه منك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا, اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا, اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا, واجعلنا هداة هاديين مهديين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا ووفقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا ووفقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا للعمل بكتابك وسنة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, واجعلنا على منهج السلف الصالح رضوان الله تعالى عليهم.